Hey, what is up guys? Guitar Rock here. Welcome to a new game. This game is called Star Healer. Currently, I believe it should be in OBT as of me downloading this open beta test. But it should be available to any players regardless, right? So what is this game all about? It's a very unique game with gacha elements, but it's a shooting game, as far as I know, much more of a bullet hell style game. So I'm going to show you guys the gameplay, but before that, quick shout out to LD Player for sponsoring this video. Now, LD Player is an Android emulator, and if you guys are not aware, it allows you to play, you know, any mobile games on Android on your PC. Now, as you can see, I'm running this on LD Player with my mouse, with my keyboard. You can see the bindings here, WASD to move around, and then you have all of these keys going on right now. Alright, let's show you what this game is all about. You can see right now I'm controlling this little girl in a spaceship. So let's see, I need to move to the left to access the interface to move to the planets. And I can show you guys what this game is all about. Alright, so let's interact. So you can see I'm allowed to choose between multiple planets. So I've completed the chapter 1 Fruit Land, so chapter 2 Frozen Land, and then chapter 3 will be Kitten Land, Funny Land for chapter 4, Odd Sweet Land for chapter 5, Color Land for chapter 6, Happy Land for the last one currently. And there's an extra independent for later contents, right? So let's go. We're going to try out the Frozen Land for the time being. 2-1 Snow's Barrier. Now you can see the aesthetics of this game is a little bit different. It's very, very unique, right? So you get to see a bunch of very simplistic art, but simple in a good way, right? Not necessarily bad. It's like, it's simple, but it still looks kind of nice. It has its own unique style. Okay, notice I have three characters using right now, and one of my characters has the ability to summon the tentacles. The tentacles is randomly hitting the enemies. So notice this particular stage, I need to beat 20 enemies. So that's the goal. So every stage, there's, as far as I know, there's no like 1-star, 2-star, 3-star requirements. It's just you beat the stage by doing the required objective, right? So tap back to the cabin, something new seems to appear. Let's go. So what new level unlock? Okay, so let's have a look. What new level do we have? Okay. So plot mode is unlocked. So let's have a look. What is this all about? So experience the plot for great rewards. Okay, so you can experience this story. Okay, so we got Sakura again. Alright, so you can watch the story if you want to get the bonuses and stuff. Pretty cool that they added those things as well. So let's power up my character. So far, there is gacha in the game. So far, these are the characters that I have, which is a little bit weird, right? So we have Sakura right here. This is the main little girl that you get early on. So I got this summer squid guy. I think it's the... Let's power this up. I want to power up the summer squid since I can star up as well. Star up the characters. Wait, what? My squid evolved into a lolly? No way! No way, from tentacles to lolly? Okay, I'll take it. Okay, now that's a new one, so let's up it even more. So by the way, we consume battery, so now I need these things to power her up. Stage 1-10. Okay, so let's bring you guys to the stage 1-10. This is where you fight the boss. So I want to show you guys the boss as well. It's pretty cool. Oh, there's a sweet feature. Do you guys see that? There's a sweet feature that you can use. Alright, but regardless, I just want to play a normal one and show you guys the boss stage. Now, usually you will enter this particular screen, as you can see, the character itself, and then you can choose the character, and then you can choose their so-called weapon that they use. So this one is using a pulley, this one is a mango popsicle, and the one I'm using was Genie Rainbow Zero. So you can see the stats, the attack speed and stuff, it will increase accordingly. And you can put a pet as well, right? So I wonder if the pet does affect anything, but each of them have their own stats. So regardless, let me show you guys the team that I'm using right now. Ooh, this is the monster in the middle. Alright, so as you can see, I'm controlling three characters, so it's a little bit confusing. So my squid still have the ability. Sea Urchin Virus is the boss right here. So let's activate the ability. So E, so you can see that activates the main girl's character's Q. I activate the bat right there. I don't know if you can see, there's a lot of things happening on the screen. And R. Alright. So we defeat the boss. And we get a bunch of these things along the way. Plenty of clearance rewards right there. Battery is needed to level up, but I don't know what every single one of these is used for. I know some of it is used to level up the character. So let's go and let's see if I have enough materials to power up the tentacles, because that's the whole objective. We are powering up the tentacle girl. Squid 2 right here, so up. I need one more. So you can use assist if you want to, and assist will basically, you can use your friends and look at that. You can bring someone like, 79,000 fight power, and I think you can just destroy the stage, literally. I think that's going to be something that you can take advantage of. And you don't have to be friends with them, you can just select everyone at random. Look at this guy. This guy is so strong that the boss just died. Literal seconds. 3 seconds. Boss is dead. Right? Just like that. Genevieve 2-0. Okay, looks like whenever they power up or they go to the next stage, they have the ability to change their look. So I'm curious if the squid will change the looks. Alright, let's see. Star up from 2 star to 3 star. Oh, from lolly to grown up squid. Dang, 3 star looks different. Okay, let's have a look at the skin. So the default skin, can I go back to the previous one, I wonder? I'm guessing you can't. But believe it or not, this game actually has skins. And the soundtrack is actually pretty good as well, based on what I can see. So this is the task. Look, daily's task. Claim all. Okay, you guys can't see, it's blocked by my face cam. Off the face cam, look at this. Claim all, zoop! Easy. Easy claim all right there, right? One of the best, if not the best feature that you can have. So look at all of this. Premium currency and all collection, simulation, 7-day reward. Let's see, what do we have? So day 1, yellow star. So day 7, you get a violet guard. Okay, that looks like a legendary violet guard as well. Pretty cool, pretty cool. Okay, so right here, you can see there's a skin. Let me show you. Alright, so again, the art style in this game, pretty simple, alright? Like, I actually don't mind it. Like, look at this. This is how you will view them as the chibi characters, as you guys can see, right? Let me turn off my face cam just in case I'm blocking anything. So this is the character, the chibi character. So this is Ocean Treasure Siren. Alright, and then we have this is Waves and Castle Moontide. So look at all of this. The skin actually not bad. Alright, Blade of the Future, Violet Guard is the skin of the character that you're gonna get on day 7. Alright, and then you have Soul of Devil, Trident Mate, and Lucky Day Wendell. Alright, so I would say not too bad of a skin. Okay, so let's go to the gacha pool and see what we can pull, right? So right now I have 5.2k. This one is for Mei Mei. The thing about the gacha is there's also chance to get. So hero is 20%, weapon is 26%, part is 20%. So that's for common. 66% for common, rare 30%, legendary is 4%. Alright, in this case, Mei Mei is a legendary. Hero will be up to these characters, right? Okay, so 4% chance to get a legendary. And it could be either character, weapon, or parts, it seems. So let's have a look. I'm gonna go with this one, the most expensive option, and see what can we get. Okay. Ooh. Okay, I see a bunch of shiny. This one is not shiny. So we're gonna open up the not shiny for Azure, alright. Okay, we got Nana. Okay, we got a Silent Ice Cream. So this is a weapon. So we got Twilight, plenty of new characters. Okay, again Nana again. Okay, we got Maka, which I believe is a pet. So now, let's open the glowing shiny one. Oh, we got Overlord. Now is this... I don't know. It looks yellowish. Is it a legendary? Ooh. Urchin Cane. I don't know if that's legendary or is that the higher rarity. A Rainbow Zero. And the last one, another Urchin Cane. So it's not legendary, it's like rare, you know? So it's like common, rare, legendary. So I got a couple of rares right there, but no legendary, Satch. So it is what it is. 4% chance. I guess I didn't win it. So yeah, that's the game, guys. This is Star Healer. Again, if you guys are interested and you want to download it for yourself, feel free to use my referral link in the description below. I'll pin it in the comment as well. So let's power out this guy. As always, if you haven't already, subscribe, give this video a like. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a nice day. Goodbye.